Hi, my name's Isaac, and this is a 2021 Chevy Suburban LT. And today, I'm gonna review it for you guys. You know, honestly, I have never met people that flex their vehicle more than Suburban and Tahoe people. They're always like, yeah, the wife and kids and I were thinking about taking the Suburban out this weekend to Burger King. Okay, and you're telling me this why? Now this is an LT trim Suburban, and I'm really excited to review it for you guys because it has so many features. Now I believe there's a high country trim above this, but honestly, I don't know what that high country could have that this isn't already equipped with. So let's get started. Before we begin, I want to thank Brown Dobbs Chevy for allowing me to review this vehicle. For all your Chevy needs, you can visit Brown Dobbs right off of Nazareth Pike in Nazareth, Pennsylvania, or at their website, browndobbschevy.com. Starting out up front on this Suburban, you'll get LED headlights, these really cool wraparound LED daytime running lights, and then moving further down the grille below the Chevy logo, you'll have a camera for the 360-degree camera system. And that pretty much wraps up the front here. You do have some parking sensors. Curiously, no option for fog lights on these Suburbans. I guess they decided with the LEDs being so bright that they didn't need them. Moving underneath the hood, this Suburban is powered by GM's 5.3-liter Ecotec V8, making 355 horsepower and 383 pound-feet of torque that is mated to a 10-speed automatic transmission. Moving along to the profile of this Suburban, you have 275/50R tires wrapped around 22-inch wheels. I really like the black with the little chrome accents. I think that really offsets nicely against this color on the Suburban. You'll have your Suburban badge down here, and you do have running boards. These ones are not power like you get on the higher end Yukons. I'm imagining you could probably get the power running boards on the high country trim. Boy, here we go. Moving to this mirror, you'll have turn signal indicator. You'll have a camera integrated into it for the 360-degree camera system. It has blind spot monitoring. It's a power mirror and a heated mirror. This thing is probably worth the price of a used 1998 Honda Civic, just this one mirror. Anyway, moving down the door here, you do have keyless entry, so if you have the key in your pocket, you could just tap that, it locks it, and you could tap that, and it will unlock it right there. So that pretty much wraps up the profile here of this Suburban. This is the larger Tahoe, essentially. Moving to the back of this Suburban, there is a hidden tow hitch back here. If properly equipped, the Suburban can tow up to 8,300 pounds, which rivals most of its pickup truck counterparts, which is very good. You'll have your LT badge right here, Suburban spelled across the back. That's new for the 2021 body style. You'll also have your camera back here and this kind of chrome bar across with the Chevy emblem. Now moving to your key, there's a lot of features back here involving the key. In addition to unlock, lock, remote start, you also have the ability to pop the top glass. If you want to just fit something in there really quick, the top glass part pops up. I wish more vehicles did that. That's a pretty fun feature. And then closing that, you can also pop the entire tailgate. So this will go up and down automatically. That's becoming very common in the car industry nowadays. You'll also have your buttons here to drop the third and second row seats. Now folding the third row down, these second ones are already folded down. What you can do is you can actually hit these and they will fold up, which is really cool. When everything is folded up completely flush here, you'll have 144.7 cubic feet of storage capacity back here. That's incredible. I mean, you could fit tons of plywood back here, really anything you'd want. Moving into the interior of this Suburban, it is incredibly well equipped. Like I said before, this has pretty much every feature that I can think of on these Suburbans, very similar to the $80,000 GMC Yukon Denali that I reviewed. So without further ado, let's get to it. Let's kind of show you all the features around here. Starting with the door panel, you'll get this really nice wood trim texture right here. It's all leather, very comfortable. You'll have your mirror controls, your window controls right here. You have auto down one touch with the front two windows. Interestingly, I mentioned this on both my Silverado and Colorado review. The Colorado and the Canyon have all four one touch down windows, but even this really high Suburban doesn't have all four one touch down windows. Just a little tiny thing, but something I noted. Moving in here, oh boy, there's a ton of settings right here. There's so many buttons. You'll have your electronic parking brake. You'll have your lane departure warning. your traction control off, your parking sensors, your auto start stop feature for your engine, so when you come to a stoplight with the engine on, it'll shut it off so it can preserve fuel economy for you. You'll have a button to turn on the power outlet in the back. Below that, you'll have your four-wheel drive settings, because this is four-wheel drive. You have your headlight settings and your trailer braking assist in what looks to be some sort of credit card holder or something like that. Moving up into the gauge cluster, you'll have two traditional gauges with four tiny ones on the top and a small screen in the center. That's going to give you your digital readout for your miles per hour, your drive mode if you're in two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, park, neutral, reverse, drive, your direction. Moving over, you can get your radio station on here, your Bluetooth, your navigation, and all the settings on there. Pulling out to the steering wheel, this is going to have buttons in the back for your volume and your channel changing, as well as your cruise control settings, your front collision warning, it looks like, your heated steering wheel, and your Bluetooth settings, and the controls to control the little tiny screen inside the gauge cluster. Moving to the right there, it's gonna have the new GM shifter. I guess you could call it a shifter. They're buttons, and I mentioned this in the Yukon Denali review I did. I actually really like this design. So basically what you do, you put your foot on the brake, it's a button for park, you pull up for reverse, that's actually gonna bring up your 360 degree camera system and your backup camera, which I really, really like. As I've mentioned, this is really crisp, probably the clearest looking screen in the industry right now. You can tap for neutral, you'll pull back for drive, and then for your kind of manual auto settings, you can just hit those buttons to shift between those modes, and then I'm gonna put it back up in park. Before we move on to the screen, I do wanna talk about the dash textures. The steering wheel is trimmed in leather, very nice. I have the heating element on, and it is really, really comfortable. Up on the dash, it's soft touch polyurethane leatherette material, and then you have that wood texture that extends along the dashboard. Really gives this Suburban a very upscale, luxurious feel. Right below the screen, you have leather down here, and then you also have two climate control vents. Moving into the screen, it is really, really cool. It's a very large screen. I believe it's a 10.2-inch screen. Very responsive, very quick. You'll have Bluetooth, Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, navigation built in, pretty much anything that you can get currently. HD radio, Sirius XM if you have a subscription for it. Everything is in this infotainment system. You can even do some of the climate controls from inside this infotainment system. A lot of vehicles have started to adopt that. I really do like it. I think overall it is a great screen. It seems to be quite responsive, and it's very high definition. Before we move below that, I don't know what this is. There's a little storage cubby right here, and I tried to stick my hand in it to find the end, and you can just find the end there. It seems like it's a bottomless pit. When I first was kind of doing an overview of the interior for what I was going to talk about, I was like, what is this? Because I couldn't reach the end. I'm like, what is this, just a void? You just drop your coins in here and they just disappear? But no, it is just like a little storage cubby. It does have an end in there. It's just an interesting, strange placement for it. So you have your hazards below that, and then you have your controls for the infotainment system. Below that, you have your climate controls, heated seat buttons, USB, USB-C, and a 12-volt outlet, and then a little storage area. You have two cup holders right here, and then popping this up, you have an SD card slot, another USB, and a USB-C, as well as a huge storage area. You can even take this little cubby drawer out for more storage room. The seats are very comfortable leather. I really like them. I think you really just sink right into them. Moving up, you do have your mirror with auto dimming on it. And then above that, you have your controls for the panoramic sunroof that this comes equipped with. And then you also do have the buttons to drop the seats and raise the seats, it looks like, actually, for your third row. So that's really cool. And then you have a button right here to open your tailgate, but you can also change the settings if you only want it to open 3/4 of the way. You can do that as well from this button. And then, as I mentioned, you have this huge panoramic sunroof. Oh, it's so nice. The entire interior of this is just incredible. Really very modern. I'm very impressed with Chevy on this one. I mean, honestly, this right here feels like what Cadillac was not even 5 years ago. General Motors has really, really upped their game on interior quality across their entire lineup, not just Chevy, but Cadillac, GMC, Buick. I don't think I'm ever going to review a Buick, and I think everybody is okay with that. All right, stepping back into the second row here, then we'll step into the third row. I'm gonna do this section in first person because I feel like this is gonna give us a better idea of the space back here, and I'm also having some mic issues. So, stepping in here, you do have Chevrolet on the door sill. That is also up at the front. But then stepping in here, you get these really comfortable captain's chairs, and you have a really good ample amount of knee room right here, leg room, and head room. And then right here, you have two cup holders, your own climate vent controls, and heated seats, as well as two USB-Cs and a household outlet down there at the bottom. I don't know if you can see that, but there is one down there. And then you have this great view out of the sunroof. It is so nice back here. Very, very well equipped. And the door panels are just as nicely trimmed as well as they are up front with that nice wood texture. And you do get a Bose sound system in here. I was playing some Charlie Brown Christmas music before this because we're filming this closer to Christmas. And it pumped. Listen, dude. The Peanuts Christmas song, that bumps on the sound system. It's great. So moving back here into the third row, you can see I have pretty good knee room here too. As I mentioned, I'm 5'10", and this is definitely okay for long road trips. I mean, this Suburban is gigantic. It's one of the biggest SUVs in the world. And, you know, this third row almost feels like the second row and leg room. I wouldn't want to be three across, three adults across back here because it is tight because of the wheel wells. But you do get another USB-C on each side, and then you do have your own climate vents up at the top here and dome lights as well. Overall, very nicely appointed in here. I'm very impressed with the Suburban overall. Alrighty, here we are driving the 2021 Chevy Suburban. First thing I notice is, you know, as big as it is very smooth. The suspension's great. I just went over a pretty big bump and the suspension just ate that right up. I would note the rear visibility is not great on this. Seeing out the back window is a little bit difficult, especially if the headrests are up. Now, Chevy does have the rear view mirror camera that you can flip up and that turns into a screen. That's just not optioned on this one specifically. You really feel like king of the road when it comes to this Suburban, and definitely when you're driving it in the Yukon as well, or the Escalade. These full-size General Motors SUVs have always kind of handled very well. That's why they've sold great for years. And with the added features and functionality that you now have, it just goes to show how far that they've come. So overall, it handles really well. It's very smooth, really eats up those bumps. Gunning the engine, it picks up pretty quickly, not amazingly quickly, but you have to do the trade-off of this being such a big SUV with so much storage capacity, so much room for passengers, that even the moderate rear visibility is forgivable because of its size. So yeah, I think that's pretty much gonna wrap up the driving segment here on the Suburban. As we wrap up here, guys, I wanna thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. I love doing these videos and I hope you enjoyed it. What would help my channel is if you could give this video a like and subscribe to my channel if you'd like to see more car reviews from me. That really allows me to be able to do more of these in the future. I'm also a Christian, so if you have any prayer requests, you can leave those in the description in the comment section below. I read all my comments. Even if I don't reply to you right away, I will be praying for you guys. As always, I like to do a daily Bible verse, so here that is. Still trying to get better at memorizing them. And lastly, I hope your vehicle lasts you a long time and it serves you well. Take care, guys.